But what else?
What else?
Is beauty all that matters to you?
What else is there?
Disney, a company that focuses on children's media, right? Since the beginning of the last century, Disney has made a name for itself by adapting popular children's tales into animated films, along with coming up with their own stuff. Personally, I preferred DreamWorks as a kid, but you know, I'm not a company that's worth billions of dollars. And you know what money brings in? Imitators. A Car's Life, Ratatouille, What's Up Balloon to the Rescue. Plenty of people have tried it. The similarities to Disney in The Swan Princess could be explained by the fact that it was directed by Richard Rich, who used to work for Disney until the 80s, following the failure of his film The Black Cauldron at the same time. Some parts are just... come on, man. But I'll get to that later. I watched this film once or twice when I was very young, and then I was reminded of it by this video by a creator called Mad Munchkin. I'd say that I wasn't disappointed by the film, but I kinda was. Mad Munchkin and I do have the same favorite composer though. I'd been debating on whether or not to make a video about this for a while, and at the beginning of last year, the YouTuber xolotte made a video about this movie discussing her thoughts about what is wrong with it.
Now, as you might have guessed, I have some issues with how the romance is handled in this movie. And a major one is the way this movie seems to forget how and why these two ended up deciding not to get married.
She has some really good points about how the two leads' relationship is one of the most, if not the most, glaring issue with the movie. I hate Derek, so I urge you to check out her video if you haven't already. Thankfully, The Swan Princess isn't a shameless no-budget animated mess with only a title in common with the film being ripped off. It actually has a lot of original content at least, but this doesn't make for a good adaptation, and it is a loose adaptation of Tchaikovsky's Swan Lake. Again, I'll get to that later. So, why is this movie so popular among review channels? Let's take a look. Without further ado, on with the review. The title card for this movie is actually great. The animation is super smooth and it looks really pretty. So, this is a movie about a prince and a princess falling in love, and it begins with their parents. Princess Odette's father, King William, and Prince Derek's mother, Queen Huberta, both decide to arrange a marriage between their children. In this scene, little Derek is seen pestering baby Odette with the necklace he's supposed to give her, but here it's not particularly mean-spirited and is more silly. This wizard guy, Rothbart, isn't super happy about Odette being born, because he wanted to succeed King William. It's explained through some exposition and visuals that Rothbart's powers were suspended somehow, and he was banished from the kingdom.
Everything you own, everything you love, will be mine.
The plan is that every summer Odette and Derek will spend time together in the hopes that this will encourage feelings to blossom between them. We get a musical number called This Is My Idea, which shows the two children growing up together and not really getting along.
We've tried all summer, but we just can't lose her!
Quick, put on some speed!
It's implied that Odette is quite shrewd growing up, and Derek really doesn't like that, at least on the surface.
I think you really sorta like her, fess up.
I'd like her better if she'd lose at cards.
I've heard complaints about this, and I'm personally not really a whole fan of the whole boys are often mean because they actually like you trope, although I think that there is some truth to it. I just wish that Derek got some kind of proper scolding from his mother for this. Other than that, this is actually the only song I like from this film.
Oh.
Is anyone else seeing this? Who is the studio trying to fool? Anyways, Derek fucks up completely and proves Odette right.
Is beauty all that matters to you?
See, I could forgive younger Derek because he was a kid and he had some time to mature. But he clearly didn't. I hate this guy, man, he sucks. Thankfully, Odette has some sense, at least for now, and rejects Derek, so the marriage is called off. All that work from their parents for nothing. No, don't do the sad look back, he sucks.
You should write a book. How to offend women in 5 syllables or less.
On their way home, William and Odette are ambushed by Rothbart, who got his powers back. Somehow. He turns into a great animal and fatally wounds William, who Derek finds.
Listen to me, Derek. It's not what it seems. It's not what it seems.
I started laughing here because, come on, could you be more cryptic? And don't bother trying to make Derek seem all heroic now. He's still a man-child in my eyes. Now, time for the event that is referenced in the title of the movie. Rothbart curses Odette to turn into a swan during the day, but she can turn back into a human at night. The only way to break this curse is if her true love makes a vow of everlasting love to her. Rothbart also agrees to release her from the spell if she agrees to marry him, so he will be king. She makes friends with a couple of animals, a turtle named Speed, voiced by Stephen Wright, a French frog named Jean Bob, voiced by John Cleese, and a puffin named Lieutenant Puffin, voiced by Steve Vinovich. It's cool and all that Nearly Headless Nick is in this movie, but originally Odette's friends were other women who had the same curse. It just seems like these were goofy characters just thrown in to appeal to kids. Odette sings a song with Derek about how they were meant to be, and it's like, why? Based on what? I thought beauty was all that mattered to him, and that bothered her? It just comes across like she's desperate to not be a swan, understandably so. Or, you know, the writing is bad. Derek goes looking in the forest for the great animal, as he hasn't given up on Odette, but mistakes the swan Odette for the beast. Thankfully, he doesn't kill her by accident, but only because Odette and Lieutenant Puffin could outwit him in time for the moon to rise. This part of the movie is actually accurate to Swan Lake. The prince does almost accidentally kill Odette, but it's only because he didn't really know her until that point, and was just swan hunting. Odette tells Derek what he must do to break the curse, and unfortunately, Rothbart overhears this and makes a plan to stop Derek from breaking the curse. In the ballet, he disguises his daughter, Odile, as Odette. Simple enough, right? Well, the same thing happens here, except I don't really know who this is. Is it Odile? Why is she so much older than him? Is she supposed to be his mum in this version of the story? There's this terrible jazz number from Rothbart, and I love jazz. I just don't know why it's in a film based on Tchaikovsky's most famous ballet. Queen Huberta holds a ball for Derek to pick a bride, and Odile arrives. Odette tries to distract Derek from Odile, but this fails and Derek professes his love to the wrong person. I do like the detail in this scene, and the rest of the movie, that Odette wears a white dress whereas Odile in disguise wears a black dress. This is because in the ballet, Odette is the white swan, and Odile is the black swan. As Derek has failed in his mission, Odette dies, and he's super melodramatic, which had me laughing my ass off again.
Do you hear? The vow I made was for her!
No need to shout.
Rothbart then turns into the great animal, a giant ugly bat, and Derek kills him in a, once more, oddly familiar manner. Odette then awakens, because they have to force a happy ending somehow, and they all live happily ever after. What, so you're gonna end on a little bit of live action because you haven't ripped off Sleeping Beauty enough? Shaking my head, man, shaking my head. Part of the reason why this movie did badly when it was released was that it got beat the fuck out by a re-release of The Lion King. I can't say that it's not deserved. If The Swan Princess was a better movie, it would have much more to show for it. Even the creator knew that, it seems. Despite this, The Swan Princess somehow managed to get 10 sequels. 10! How? There's probably going to be more of them too, it wouldn't shock me. This is worse than 80s horror franchises. They're really milking it for all it's got. And I don't really know why this movie deserved to get so many sequels, let alone one of them. Sure, it's not an offensive movie to the average consumer, but it's completely forgettable. For example, there are bits of animation, like parts that show a spell being cast, that look really good, but it also looks extremely cheap at times. I pointed it out throughout my commentary, but this movie is also just so shameless in the way it rips off Sleeping Beauty, which is actually also another play by Tchaikovsky. The two leads, Odette and Derek, aren't very captivating either. Derek is such a man-child, look at the way he acts in this scene.
Mother?
Derek.
Goodbye, princess.
Odette said it herself.
He's so immature.
Past the point of when she stands up for herself, she loses whatever personality she had, and at the same time, Derek tries to be the hero, and they're suddenly in love. All for no explained reason and with no real development from the characters. On top of that, their designs aren't even good. Derek has that ugly Tudor haircut and Odette just looks like BTEC Aurora. To add insult to injury, this film does not do Swan Lake justice at all. The film's music in general is pretty annoying and I'm sure people of any age can appreciate classical music. They could have interpolated Tchaikovsky's score into their jingles, but they didn't even bother to do that. At the very least, the singers can sing. Prince Derek isn't even called Derek originally, he's called Siegfried. No offense to people called Derek out there, but it just makes me think of the guy from Monsters vs. Aliens. There are other details, like Siegfried's weapon of choice is actually a crossbow, and I don't know why they changed it to a bow and arrow. Odette and Derek's other parents are simply implied to have died as well, but it's not clear. Even at the celebration of her birth, Odette's mum isn't there? Did she die during childbirth? The ending feels so forced and unnecessary too. There's a fake sweetness to it. Swan Lake is a tragedy and there is no happy ending. I understand how it could be too dark for children, but they could have found a way to make it less contrived. Why have Odette die at all if she's just going to come back? It just comes across as lazy. Well, that's all for this video. Be sure to follow me on social media as they are all linked in my description box. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and as always, thanks for watching.
The blue and green ones are my favorite kind, but I'll eat the colored ones from time to time, cause Polos is life, 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 sleep on.